We hope you were with us last night in Florence, South Carolina for a great WCW arena event. And listen up, fans in Charleston, because World Championship Wrestling is headed to the Coliseum tonight. Charleston, South Carolina. Tickets available at the Coliseum box office and all scat outlets tomorrow night. Your chance to see WCW live in Savannah, Georgia. And tickets are available at the Civic Center box office and all the usual outlets.
Love Savannah. Can't wait to hit Savannah, Georgia. That's going to be awesome. Villano 5 in the ring. Still, I'm sure, not happy about what happened to his brother, Villano 4, at the hands of Canyon and Razor.
Scott, we have talked about the resiliency of these luchadors from Mexico, but that point was never driven home more than the recent Nitro event where Villano 4, the brother of Villano 5, was injured by both Raven and Canyon. Combination move, I believe it was the powerbomb and neckbreaker at the same time that injured Villano 4. But we understand that he is already back in the ring in action. You just can't keep the stars of Lucha Libre down.
No question about it. And Villano 5 tonight will not be facing a member of the Raven Canyon Axis. He will be taking on Hugh Morrus, who has the Barbarian and Jimmy Hart at ringside.
Well, the numbers game certainly points to Hugh Morrus here with the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, as well as the Barbarian at ringside. Villano 5 doesn't even have his own brother, Villano 4, in his corner.
The buzz in this building is unbelievable. Everyone is awaiting the appearance of the Four Horsemen. What will the Horsemen have to say tonight on Saturday night? We saw Eric Bischoff and his goon squad from NWO Hollywood have the Horsemen taken away by the local gendarmes Monday night on Nitro. I want to hear what Ric Flair has to say. I want to hear what Arn Anderson says, and Benoit, and Malenko, and Mongo. I want to hear it all tonight, and we will later during this broadcast.
Well, Eric Bischoff is just out of control. Fortunately for us, he is not in the arena tonight. There's no way that he can stop us from having that Four Horsemen interview, and Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, and company are going to set the record straight this evening on WCW Saturday night.
Well, if I know Eric Bischoff, right now, he is furiously dialing his phone, trying to get somebody here at the building to keep Flair and the Horsemen from making an appearance and grabbing a live mic.
Well, I hope that he calls the head of security for World Championship Wrestling, Doug Dillinger, because Dillinger, a Charlotte, North Carolina resident, and Ric Flair, well, they go back a long way, and I think that Dillinger, if anything, is going to walk Flair right out for the interview.
I certainly hope so. Good luck, Eric. We're not taking your call. Hugh Morrus puts Villano 5 right across that metal steel cable, now opening up. Referee Scott Dickinson trying to break it up, but no go. Hugh Morrus.
Hey, look at this. Barbarian outside. Cheap shot, just choking him.
Oh, throttling him right there across the metal steel cable. And Hugh Morrus will take advantage of that, but he may not need that. That assistance to the Barbarian. Hugh Morrus looking good tonight.
Yeah, well, Jimmy Hart cheers him on at ringside like that's some kind of accomplishment. Clothesline took Villano 5 off of his feet.
Lateral press cover by Hugh Morrus. He got the two count on Villano 5. Hugh Morrus sporting a new do, as it were, Mike Tanay.
Look at that closely cropped buzz cut now on Hugh Morrus. Hoping that that, along with Jimmy Hart and the Barbarian, chance to turn his career around in World Championship Wrestling. You know, he has all the physical tools. There's never been a question about that with Hugh Morrus. Well over 300 pounds, but with the ability and the agility to do a top rope moonsault, among other high-risk moves. He can beat you in so many different ways, and with that size and power, we see him now in quite a predicament as Villano 5 has him hooked up, but just the overall strength of Hugh Morrus just allows him to shrug Villano 5 off.
Morrus just threw Villano 5 out of that python, and Villano 5 probably more staggered than anything else that Morrus was able to escape. Suplex by Hugh Morrus. Center of the ring, lateral press, and again a two count on Villano 5.
And Hugh Morrus goes right back to work following up the advantage, neutralizing Villano 5 with this move while he checks with Jimmy Hart for strategy at ringside.
You gotta think that somewhere at NWO Hollywood Corporate, there is a serious lack of trust. Who is going to be the next person to jump ship? from NWO Hollywood to the One Warrior Nation. That has got to have Hollywood Hogan worrying himself to sleep at night.
Well, the Warrior told us that the Disciple was merely step one.
Oh, yeah.
We keep waiting to find out if there's going to be another person from the NWO Black and White that decides to come over and join the Warrior in his revolution.
Did you see that? Slingshot Blotcha by Villano 5, and Morrus just caught him in midair, and Barbarian put the kick of fear to the back of the head for good measure. Now Hugh Morrus is going up top.
Here goes the big man to the top. 330 pounds.
Oh, no.
Moonsault style, but no laughing matter off the top.
That's it. Scott Dickinson counts him out, and Hugh Morrus with the no laughing matter will score the pinfall over Villano 5. That's an impressive victory right there, Mike.
When he hits that top rope moonsault, it guarantees him the last laugh. Look at Jimmy Hart, right in his face. How do you control a guy with a look like that?
I don't want to get near him, much less control him. Barbarian's happy, and Hugh Morrus, a smile creeping across his face.
Bottom line, it's that ability, and it's the agility of the big man, Hugh Morrus, that pays off for him with an impressive win over Villano 5 on Saturday night.